First of all, a big congratulations to In Touch initiative. I think it's been a great forum. We've been able to see, you know, many of the current practices through this online platform. And a special thank you to Usha and also Ranjana for inviting me to do this conversation with C.G. Krishnan. Before I go into, you know, asking some questions to C.G., I would just like to kind of give maybe an introduction and also, you know, create a premise for, you know, C.G. to speak. As the world is going through uncertain times, and we see most of the artists struggling to come to terms with reality. I've been, you know, speaking with many of my friends, and they have been expressing their, you know, existential angst and their trouble in getting into creative space. And there's also, you know, a tremendous, you know, pressure and a sense of numbness, which most of them are feeling. But in that context, I mean, you know, many of my conversations with C.G. in recent times has been very fascinating, because she's one artist I felt that, you know, found her space. I mean, she's been able to think through. She's found a place to contemplate and also produce a remarkable body of work in recent times. That's the work which is going up also in this particular exhibition. Just to give you an introduction about C.G. as an artist, 36-year-old C.G. Krishnan was born in Melampalli, Mavelikara in Alappuzha district. This is a region which is known as the Venice of the East. And one of the beautiful districts filled with you know, canals, backwaters, lagoons and beaches. And interestingly, this region is also known as you know, the rice bowl of Kerala. And C.G. completed her you know, bachelor's in 2005 from college and from Mavelikara. She was very close to her own birthplace, and she did master's from Hyderabad University in 2007. And you know, one interesting aspect about C.G. is that I mean, her works has been collected internationally, and it has gone into institutions, you know, all across. But one, you know, remarkable thing which I feel for any artist is that, I mean, you know, your work getting collected by your own fellow artists. So I think C.G.'s works are in, you know, many collections in, you know, some of our artist friends, you know, homes. And as you all know, I mean, C.G. is a passionate painter, and her fascination towards portrait, but I would say that, I mean, not portrait, I mean, her fascination towards painting people is, you know, very, 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 very popular. But one thing which has been, you know, discussed about C.G.'s career is that, I mean, C.G. as a person who expresses parental love, you know, through her work. But you see a difference in her argument is also like, I mean, she painted a paternal love, especially in the early years of her career. And you know, we have seen in history, like, I mean, you know, many artists, you know, since many centuries have done, you know, portraits of their parents, and especially, you know, fathers. We have even many Indian examples. But C.G. always insists that, I mean, you know, her father was very, you know, very, very special for her. But what attracts me to, you know, C.G.'s work, is also, there's a sense of, you know, primitive temperament and a presence of earth, you know, the colors, the ochre, and in a very casual, you know, layering in her style. And the expressions her figures carry, you know, I always feel that, I mean, she provokes, you know, us to look at human species as civilizational being. And I always wondered that, I mean, whether locating you know, the history and the connections this region has or region had with, you know, the larger world, and also the ancient memories, and also the recent political histories of that region has played in a big role in, you know, making Siji an artist of, you know, special, you know, concerns and aesthetics. I leave that, you know, part for art historians and, you know, anthropologists to look at. Coming, you know, closer to, you know, to Suji's works. Coming to the first question, could you please take us through, you know, the early years of your career, you know, learning, you know, painting, and also, you know, speak a little bit more, you know, with us about, you know, the most celebrated aspect of your career, Father the Hero. Suji?
Yes. I'm so grateful to have a conversation with you. Riyaz, thank you. And thank you, Ranjana Steyn Group and the whole Intouch team. So for me, it's very difficult for me to talk about my father, because I felt that the words are not enough to explain him, because of that I am painting. And, you know, my father was my first inspiration, and his presence and as well as his absence makes me to build up me as an artist. And I drew since my childhood. My father was the one who recognized the artist in me. And whenever he go out, he used to collect some calendar paintings for me. And some kind, it's like some kind of a god image, like some beautiful women's pictures, and some kind of sceneries. And he always told me to copy that. Even I tried to copy that, the same thing, I can't do that, because I add something of my own. So then only I feel that it's something is coming from inside. So even that time also, I felt that some, I feel that something has to come in from our own. So I don't believe in imitation is an art form in that time. And, you know, after coming back from his job, he looked at the paintings and said to me, this is Bhavana Chitram in Malayalam. That's my mother tongue. And the meaning is imaginary pictures. And, you know, a lot of my works has having a relation with the father and the daughter. And this is my father. And, he, you know, he have a really a similar body of a female body. And he's a more like a very loving person. And this is the same thing I do in my childhood. This is 2008, my father passed away. And I can't afford that pain, because the pain was more inside me. So this is more like for me, it's a kind of a soul soothing experiences. And I did a portrait of the fathers a lot. And this is I exhibited in the Kashi Art Gallery. This is called the Lullaby series about my father. And this is among 10, this one of that work, all the work I did 10. So this is called Lullaby series. It's highly, very detailed work. And this is the work I got a first exploration in first Kochi Museris Biennale. So three of the work are exhibited in the Kochi Museris Biennale that time.
In most of you know, our conversations, I have felt that your mother was your father, and your, you know, father was your mother. I think But you have not spoken much about your mother, you know, as an artist. You know, I remember you mentioning that in very early in your life, while you were studying art, because of your father's innocence and your mother's boldness to kind of, you know, lead a very strong life, to save the pride of the family, you know, she took a very important decision, and because of that, you know, you people lost the house. I think you all became homeless, and you had a very difficult art learning, you know, period. I mean, especially this happened at the time that while you were studying. I mean, could you, you know, please take us through, you know, those incidents of your life?
You know, homelessness make one person uncomfortable, but for me, it was not. And I believe that earth is my home and the sky was my shelter. And then I think I got much more wider space then. And, you know, of course, I passed through a very, very difficult situation in my college days. And, you know, my father was a bank employee. And some issues happens in bank, and we got lost everything. Mm-hmm. And that time, I was studying in Hyderabad Central University. You know, I'm not able to go during the vacations time to see my parents. So because I can't go. There is so much problems for money and all. So you know, the rules and regulations are very accurate in that time in the colleges. So I was really get out from the hostel, and I don't have a place to sleep that time. Then I found this place, space of my own, and it was the upstairs. It was the ladies' hostels upstairs. There is a water tank, and so I, in the night, I used to climb there. So then I slept there. I slept there, and you know, starry night was my shelter. And you know, and then I felt that that is the most happiest night I ever had in my life. Yeah. My mother was really very strong woman. She's an ordinary housewife, but with no ordinary things. And she is always behind me, always push me. And, you know, two of my work has an indirect influence from her.
Yeah.
One day, I opened my door. I saw a bird dead in front of my door. So what I did, I take the bird inside, and I have a tendency to draw everything in the row. So slowly, some of the drawings after the ants are coming to beat this bird. So what I did, I take a plate, and I pour some water. Then I put a mug, and on the top of that, I put a paper, and I put this bird. And the same technique my mother used to do it for the coconut and sugar. So this is how I'm relating with my mother. And you know, this is Mama with Dali's mustache, but this is not portraying my mother. This is, I took a photograph from something like emotionally feeling that love of a mother and a daughter. So then I put, she's more a stronger woman. So that's why I put taken Dali's mustache.
It actually brings into your, you know, series of work where, you know, you come across as a desperate storyteller. And it's reflecting in your series of work which you did titled Family Series. And in those works, I mean, you see a certain kind of, you know, a period. I mean, you know, sometimes it looks like a 100-year-old Kerala photograph. It looks like a different kind of a human settlement. These works also, to some extent, carries a very different kind of or a distinct aesthetics. I think the works looks like, a neighborhood, with full of stories, and there is a presence of yourself in it in most of the works. And these are very intricate, ways of telling stories. Could you please explain a little bit more about, who are those people? Siji?
Yeah. And, I was coming from a village. Because of that, most of the village life was embedded in me. And most of these paintings are the journeys of memories. And memories of people from my experience. And memories of a few stories I have heard from elderly people in my childhood and other living beings. And of that surroundings of that landscape. And apart from all that, it's a curiosity inside me to explore those memories back in time, searching and researching like a possibility and to explore those memories from like my mother's womb. And it's an edge of that experience. Mm-hmm. This is family portrait. And this is exhibited in the Moscow Biennale too. So these all are like, this work is a very large format. Earlier I was like a kind of a small format I have. So now it's a kind of a children's are playing some here in a side and other side. So this was like more like stories from my villages.
I remember you mentioned that.
Yes, in the Moscow Biennale, because I scared that how the people react from the Moscow Biennale. So the people from Moscow, they see this painting and they are relating their life, their village life, and they told me something like similar kind of people playing, everything is like there is something relate to that. So I think the art has not it conveys with the work itself, so no need to tell anything.
There are a few more works.
Yeah, this is a Creek family.
Yeah.
It was because some in some ways I felt like I want to deviate from my own personal things. So if you go to your own personal things, I felt like you will stuck in one position or something like that. So I want to do very, very, very different thing. So it's a Creek family. And I did many mistakes also. Then I keep the mistakes aside. This is again the father portrait. We can see the landscape behind. Some kind of touches are there.
Yeah, this is a work which I thought I'll ask you a different question, because according to this is also one of the trees which you represent in many of your works, that the presence of very ancient sensibility. But according to Hindu mythology, the leaf of banyan tree is a place that where a place of Lord Krishna's he rests on this banyan tree leaves. And I was just trying to kind of to ask you about there is a sense of romance which you don't see in any of the other works. Here you have climbed on top of that tree and you are you're sleeping on top of it, and your hair is growing down almost like a root. Can you speak a little bit more about it?
I think there is no connection with any religious or mythical stories. You know, once I was sitting beside a tree in my home, and I was a little bit sad that day, and I don't know the reason. You know, the pain was in not going inside from me, and then slowly I start to talk to the tree. Then sometimes I touch him and enjoying its roughness of the skin. Then after that, I hug the tree, and so at last the pain was shared. And then I thought to do some portrait of a tree, and you know, it's a four or five portraits of trees I did, and have some little self portraits also. So, and each tree I know them very intimately.
Now let's you know, go into the series of work which you're showing as part of this InTouch initiative. I think this is a shift also happened in your work in this COVID times, and you're almost like moving away from your storytelling, you know, tendencies. And in one way, these works and even the conversation we had about this work, I mean, took us very much back to, you know, the memories of your father. I mean, you know, the presence of your father in your early works were, you know, of a different kind. And today, you know, while we speak with you, I mean, you know, we understand that, I mean, you know, you're having an intellectual discourse with father after, you know, 12 years of his passing away. And it has happened through one advice which he gave you to read Atmobhadesha Shatakam, which was written by one of the greatest social reformers of Kerala, and we all call him as Sri Narayana Guru. I mean, Atmobhadesha Shatakam is like, I mean, the literal translation of that is like 100 verses of self-instruction. And you said that you've taken your father's advice very seriously only in recent times. I mean, since last 1 year, especially in this COVID year, I mean, period, you've been reading Atmobhadesha Shatakam almost every evening. And you said that, I mean, that is having a transformative effect, and it's also coming into your work as kind of a different presence of father's advice, and also the advice which Guru gave it to the Kerala community. Can you, you know, take us through, you know, your recent works?
Yes. You know, I was keep on reading Atmobhadesha Shatakam for a year in the evening time. And, you know, without knowing its meaning, I kept on reading. And, you know, during this corona time, I was arranging my shelf. And I found a book of Atmobhadesha Shatakam by M. Shastrikar. It's an interpretation. And, you know, that is the book gifted from my father 17 years back. And now I feel like he wants to tell me something through this book. And, you know, I feel that there is a key was inside me, and which I don't know something. He have to tell me something through that. Still, I'm a seeker now. And just if I read some words like aham aham ennariyunnathokke aarayugil agame paladalla adegamagum, that means everything goes into one. So those kind of words are really like haunting me inside. And So these all are coming to my portrait series, this new series work. And
I'm sure, you know, many of our friends who've joined to hear you speak must be having some interesting questions also to ask you. I mean, so let's open it to the floor.
Not at all pre-planned, you know. I don't go, means I am not prepared for anything. So once I draw a picture, it's like it's naturally coming to me. It's a kind of a natural process, and I can't predict myself. That's the thing that's happening. And I use this rice paper, many kind of layering techniques and all, but it's more like I have a feeling like some in a certain period, I feel like an old book was inside me, and it was something like more kind of a layering kind of a thing. So. And when I look at that, that is whole is memory. So that the natural things and all this come to this kind of a rice paper. Because of that, I'm using the rice paper. Gives me a lot. I got more exploration and. That was the first time I'm going to Japan, and it was like it's like an effort. I have a feeling of that I have something has to come to your work. It should be like an effortless conversation, and it should not be like like a kind of storytelling. No, that storytelling part is gone away from me. So I enjoyed those days in Japan.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. I guess everyone.
Also, and one interesting thing is that when she was in Japan, and she was the day she was leaving Japan is when there was the typhoon. This was in October. And she had to fight against the climate and rain and wind and storm to get to the train station. Mm-hmm. And somehow she survived that. Also, I think the 3 months in Japan, the kind of, adventurous spirit that you showed there, participating in all the local activities and it was quite remarkable, which, one doesn't think that you have that kind of guts to go mm-hmm. out and be with new people and strangers. And also in these portraits, as you said, you moved from people you knew very intimately, from your husband and your mother, to strangers, complete strangers. And you kind of dropped the outline and you went, as you said, towards the light and a complete, melting of the figure into the background. So maybe that's all this impulse of going out into the world and being one. I don't know. I mean, that's my feeling of how this mm-hmm. all comes together in the last 6 to 8 months. Then also what you and I talked about is this reduction in palette, and you're not building up the surface, you're not building up richness and texture and color, has to do with this sense of, slowing down and reduction and loss that we're facing in this time, which I think Riaz also referred to at the beginning of the discussion.
Observation was correct. And, I have the capacity if something is coming into me. I will face that, you know, that some strength was always inside me. And if you fell down anywhere, you will only think about how to get outside. So those is naturally inside me. Yeah,
certainly that makes you stronger when you've had that kind of, adversity in life.
What I wanted to ask was that I remember the conversation started with how you love to paint people. And it's not just about the photos, it's also about the people that you're painting, right? So, putting it all in one sentence, people are important for your artwork in a way. It's been, I think, approximately 5 months or so since the interaction with people has gone down, like, to some other limit. If your works come from people and not just your own emotions, not just from the personal, but also what you see outside, so suddenly this change of the world, how are you dealing with this? How are you dealing with the subject? Yeah, the corona thing and the lockdown. So you have to be situated in a place and not a lot of movement is there. So there's not a lot of perception other than your own, right? So how do you deal with that sudden shift in your work? Because I can see that you're still working and you're still painting. So I just wanted to know that how do you, pull yourself forward to do this, to do the same.
And you know, this corona time is really a kind of a refreshing time for me. Earlier, I had some kind of a wall in between. I kept the wall because I need that wall. So even this corona time, the wall was very decreased. The height of the wall was very decreased, I felt. And you know, we were cooking means more like closer to the neighbors. So. And it feels like more like the inner feeling of to do a portrait of a person. So that I did these portraits, and it's more like not a physical appearance. So I want to portray the inner portrait of people.
That's really
so that's
nice.
What you know. That's what I want. What I want to tell means, if I want to express the old sensory elements, like if you can you cannot express the touch, some emotions, and we cannot express through words. So that's all the sensory elements I want to catch up. So if it is the smell, and you can express through words or anything. So that's what I was trying to do this portrait. So these all are, that's why maybe the light colors are coming and all. Have some kind of shifts are always happening between works. Means you can see after Father series there is a shift. So I felt like something like an empty space was inside me, and you know it. That's the process of like I do something, some of my work, and I'm throwing it out. So the same those processes are happening those time. You know then. Then I don't push myself anything, and something has to come naturally.